Last time we talked about the fake sourdough problem and the real health benefits of genuine fermentation. Today, I want to get specific about something I see constantly in my practice. Patients with irritable bowel syndrome who've been told to avoid bread entirely. Here's what most people don't know. It's not the bread itself that's the problem. It's what's in the bread, and real sourdough changes that completely. Let me tell you about a landmark Australian study published in Gastroenterology in 2014. Researchers at Monash University took 30 people with IBS and fed them two different diets for 3 weeks each. One diet was low in FODMAPs. The other was a typical Australian diet with a normal FODMAP content. The results, symptom scores were cut in half on the low FODMAP diet. Bloating, abdominal pain, gas, all dramatically improved. And here's what's crucial. This wasn't a small effect. 70% of participants had clinically significant improvement. So what are FODMAPs? FODMAPs stands for fermentable oligosaccharides, disaccharides, monosaccharides, and polyols. It's a terrible acronym, I know, but what it means is simple. These are short-chain carbohydrates that your small intestine cannot absorb properly. In wheat and rye, the grains used for most bread, the main FODMAP culprit is fructans. These are chains of fructose molecules that humans simply cannot digest, zero capacity. They pass straight through to your colon, where bacteria ferment them rapidly, producing hydrogen gas, bloating, and pain. For people with IBS, this is catastrophic. Their guts are hypersensitive to this fermentation and the resulting distension. Now, here's where sourdough becomes genuinely medicinal. During that 8 to 24 hour fermentation I talked about last time, something remarkable happens to those fructans. The lactic acid bacteria in real sourdough, particularly strains like Lactobacillus plantarum, L. brevis, and L. sanfrancisensis, produce enzymes called fructan hydrolases. These enzymes systematically break down the fructan chains into simple sugars, fructose and glucose. Then, and this is the key, the bacteria consume those sugars for their own metabolism. The end result, a 70 to 90% reduction in FODMAP content. That's enough to bring a slice of sourdough below the threshold that triggers symptoms in most IBS patients. We're talking about bread that was medically problematic becoming genuinely tolerable. Three mechanisms make this possible. First, bacterial enzymes. Those lactobacilli produce specific enzymes that attack fructans. Commercial baker's yeast cannot do this effectively. It simply doesn't have the enzymatic machinery. Second, fermentation time. You need 8 to 24 hours minimum for complete fructan breakdown. That 2-hour supermarket sourdough, completely ineffective. The enzymes haven't had time to work. You're getting full FODMAP content with a sour taste added via vinegar or citric acid. Third, acidity. That low pH we talked about last time, around 3.8 to 4.3, activates not just the bacterial enzymes, but also the wheat's own endogenous fructanases. The grain itself has enzymes that can break down fructans, but they need acidic conditions to activate. Sourdough provides exactly that environment. The Monash study didn't specifically test sourdough, but subsequent Finnish research did. They used sourdough fermentation with selected lactobacillus strains to create low FODMAP rye bread. In IBS patients, this bread significantly improved abdominal symptoms and reduced hydrogen breath concentrations, a marker of colonic fermentation. Now, let me be clinically precise about something important. Sourdough doesn't help IBS by removing gluten. That's a common misconception. While the fermentation does partially break down gluten proteins, making them easier to digest, that's not the primary mechanism for IBS relief. The relief comes from FODMAP reduction, period. This is why patients who've been diagnosed with gluten sensitivity often do fine with genuine sourdough. It was never gluten causing their symptoms, it was fructans. The sourdough eliminated the actual trigger while leaving enough gluten structure to make proper bread. Let me give you the clinical bottom line from decades of practice. I've had countless patients tell me they can't eat bread. When I dig deeper, what they mean is bread gives them terrible bloating, cramping, and altered bowel habits. Classic IBS symptoms triggered by FODMAPs. I send them to a real bakery, one that does overnight fermentation with a genuine starter culture. They come back astonished. I can eat bread again, not because they were imagining their symptoms before, but because the biochemistry of the bread has fundamentally changed. But here's my warning, and I cannot emphasize this enough. Most bread labeled sourdough in supermarkets will not help you. It's made with commercial yeast in 2 to 3 hours. The FODMAP content is identical to regular bread. You're paying premium prices for flavoring agents. To get the medicinal benefit, the actual FODMAP reduction, you need genuine sourdough starter, not commercial yeast, minimum 8-hour fermentation, ideally 12 to 24 hours, and a baker who can tell you their processes. Ask the questions. Check the ingredients. Real sourdough is flour, water, salt, and starter culture. That's it. Here's the takeaway. If you have IBS, bloating, or think you're gluten sensitive, you're not necessarily sentenced to a bread-free life. Genuine long-fermented sourdough reduces FODMAPs by up to 90% through bacterial fermentation. But you must be strategic. Find real bakeries. Ask about fermentation time. Avoid the fake stuff. The science is clear. Sourdough fermentation fundamentally changes the biochemistry of wheat. It's not marketing. It's enzymology. Subscribe to MedHeads for more evidence-based health information. I'm Dr. Ferghal Armstrong.